Welcome to my channel. I am Dr. Leela A.M. bringing you series of lectures in the subjects of Electrical and Electronics Engineering. Impulse Response and Convolution Integral. Impulse response is the response of LTI system for an input which is impulse. So consider the LTI system here. If x of t is the input, this x of t is operated by the system operator and we get the output y of t. If in particular, if the input is an impulse, then we get the response and that response is termed as the impulse response and it is designated as small h of t. So mathematically we can write output y of t as system operator operating on the input signal x of t. And impulse response h of t is the system operator operating on the input delta of t. From the property of impulse signal, we know that integral minus infinity to plus infinity f of t delta of t minus t naught dt is equal to f of t naught. That is, if any signal f of t is multiplied by a shifted impulse, shifted by an amount equal to t naught, and integrated over the whole time minus infinity to plus infinity, what we get is the function value at time t is equal to t naught, because only at t is equal to t naught, delta of t minus t naught value is 1 and for all other time it is 0. So the product, this product exists only for t is equal to t naught, and hence when we integrate it over the whole time interval from minus infinity to plus infinity, what we get is the function value at t naught. So we can write the input x of t instead of a general function f of t. I am taking x of t as minus infinity to plus infinity x of tau delta of t minus tau d tau. So here tau is a dummy variable in place of time. We have written another variable tau, which is a dummy variable, and the shift we are representing by the small t. So this signal x of tau, when it is multiplied by delta of t minus tau, delta of t minus tau is folded impulse signal shifted by an amount equal to t. So this folded shifted impulse, when it multiplies the input signal x of tau, we get the value of x of tau at tau is equal to t. So that is x of t. So we can write x of t as equal to minus infinity to plus infinity integral x of tau delta of t minus tau. So you may get the doubt that here it was not folded. Why here it is folded? So the exact reason for folding will be explained in another video. The link will be given in the description box. But how these two are same is explained now. So we have the impulse signal delta of tau with respect to the dummy variable tau given in this figure. And the folded signal delta of minus tau is same as delta of tau, because both occurring at tau is equal to 0. Now if you shift delta of tau to the right by an amount equal to t, it is delta of tau minus t, which is given in this figure. So instead of shifting delta of tau by an amount t to the right, the same effect we can obtain by shifting the folded signal to the right. A folded signal is shifted to the right by adding the amount of shift by which it has to be shifted. So that is delta of minus tau is the folded signal, and we want to shift it to the right by an amount equal to t. So we add this t to the folded signal delta of minus tau. So this is delta of minus tau plus t, which is same as delta of t tau minus t. Now we can reorganize this minus tau plus t as t minus tau. So this delta of t minus tau is same as delta of tau minus t. That is why we have written here, instead of tau minus t, we have written t minus tau. So the input signal, we can write it as this integration. So from the equations 1 and 4, so system operator operating on this input, we can write the output as equal to h operating on the signal, input signal x of t. That is, system operator h operating on, now replace x of t by this integral given in the equation 4, that is my integral minus infinity to plus infinity x of tau delta of t minus tau d tau. Now, since the system is linear, we can interchange this integral and the system operator operations and write this as integral minus infinity to plus infinity x of tau. System operator operates the signal with respect to this t, whereas integral operates with respect to tau. So we have this integration and system operator separated as in this equation 5. Okay. So we can write the output y of t as equal to minus infinity to plus infinity integral x of tau, system operator operating on this impulse signal which is shifted. So that is first brought forward to this slide and is the equation 5. But what is this h of delta of t minus tau? System operator, when operates on this impulse, shifted impulse, we get an output which is shifted impulse response. So h of delta of t minus tau is equal to small h of t minus tau. So this property is due to time invariance property of the system. So now let us replace this system operator term in this equation 5 by small h of t minus tau, it is shifted impulse response of the system. So we get the output y of t as equal to integral minus infinity to plus infinity x of tau h of t minus tau d tau. This is the relation 7. This relation is known as the convolution integral or the superposition integral, and it is symbolically represented as x of t star h of t, and it is read as x of t convolution with h of t. So we have the output y of t for any input x of t as the convolution of that input with the impulse response of the system, and it is evaluated as integral minus infinity to plus infinity x of tau h of t minus tau d tau. So now we can split this integral, which is from minus infinity to plus infinity, as into two parts. So considering the time t naught as the time instant at which we are applying the input to the system, we split the whole time duration into two parts. One is from minus infinity to t naught. During this period, the input is not there applied. And another is from t naught to infinity. So during this period, input is applied. So the output is split into two parts. One is integral minus infinity to t naught x of tau h of t minus tau d tau plus integral t naught to infinity x of tau h of t minus tau d tau. So here only for the second part of the integration the input is applied, whereas the first part we have not applied any input during this time period. So from where this output comes from the system, even though we have not applied any input, that is due to any stored energy in the system. For example, if you take an electrical circuit consisting of capacitor and inductors, so they are the energy storing elements of an electrical circuit. If there is any initial voltage on the capacitor or any initial current flowing through the inductor, even without the application of the input, we get a response, and that response is termed as the zero input response, and it is given by this integral. So integral minus infinity to t naught x of tau h of t minus tau d tau is termed as the zero input response, and this response is due to only any initial stored energy of the system. The energy storage elements may be mechanical, pneumatic, fluidic, electrical, whatever it is, whatever the energy stored, that is, that gives rise to the output part of this. This is also termed as the transient response of the system, which will die out as the energy is dissipated. Energy that is stored in the element will be dissipated as the time grows. And the second part of the integral is T naught to infinity integral xf tau h of t minus tau d tau. This is termed as the zero state response. So during this period from T naught to infinity, no energy storage. The whole system is in a zero state, and the output is only due to the application of the input. So this is termed as the zero state response. So the first part is zero input response, and the second part is the zero state response. That's all for today. Thank you. If the content of this channel is useful to you, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to my channel. Thank you.